And finally, I have issue with these advisors to the president. Every issue that arises in the country, appoint new advisor to the president. If there is any minor issue, they will say, let's appoint a new advisor. He will better advise the president. The number of advisors that are appointed to advise the president on whatsoever is enough. And I think we will even start reducing some of them if we get to committee stage. We cannot continue having all these advisors at the office of the president. It's not possible. On what? We are talking about policy and program to develop our country. You are advising the president on what? Tell us. And who are these advisors? You found anyone on the street, you appointed that person as an advisor because that person was supporting you politically. So you found the person anywhere, whether educated or not, you appoint the person, whether the person is advising you correctly or not, you still left the individual there, consuming our money, the taxpayers' money we are talking about here, Honorable Speaker. We cannot continue seeing this number of advisors to the office of the president. It is the ultimate responsibility of the National Assembly members to decide whether we have to maintain all these advisors to be absorbing the taxpayers' money or not. If we said no to it, it will not happen. And nothing absolutely can be done. So we need to unanimously agree on some of these things, to eliminate some of these things, and better utilize the taxpayers' money into the productive sector of the economy. Thank you very much, Honorable Speaker.
Thank you. Thank you, Honorable.